What word?
For hangman.
Mars.
You can't say it.
Okay. What are you drawing here, Theodore? What is all this?
November 5th, 2016. I was having dinner with my brothers, my niece, and nephew, and my mind was focused on the task at hand. I had to create a documentary, an art form that I'm not comfortable with. There's a vast array of topics to choose from, of course, but I was thinking about hip-hop culture. But my one lead into that direction, well, we were just in a stubborn debate at the moment where I wanted an apology, but she wanted one too. So, I wasn't sure if it was going to work out for me. So during dinner, I texted my old friend of mine, and he responded within that same night. Maybe he can help me out. Maybe he can point me in a direction of what I should actually capitalize on.
So I made arrangements. I'll be seeing Tommy tomorrow. And we'll be going over exactly what I gotta pull off. I mean, I still don't know exactly what I'm gonna do, so I'll see what he has to say. I'll get his opinion on it. 7:30 at night. We'll see how it is in the morning.
So I found myself in the morning recording this. I didn't know why, but I didn't know where it was going to lead, so I figured it would be a good idea. You know, it's just not it's not the easiest thing to just show up to an old friend and record out of the blue without any type of explanation as to why, so... But I did it anyways. And I was nervous. I haven't seen him in a while, and... We're talking about a guy that's, you know, he's got a brilliant mind. His friends consist of Michael Wickerly from The Dragon's Den, Peter Mansbridge, you know, City TV, The National, Galen Weston and the Weston family, who own Loblaws and Shoppers, Margaret Atwood, you know, big politicians in general, big lawyers. And here I am showing up and recording him. I don't know, was this the beginning? This isn't something I'm used to, but I was debating whether I should go about recording this or telling him I wanted to record it. But whatever, I kept the camera rolling. So I waited, and I was so nervous, I ate because I didn't know what his reaction to me filming him would be. So I got that out of the way. Just shortly after that, I just indulged in my coffee and just, again, sat and enjoyed the scenery. And waited. I was debating messaging him. Telling him I was gonna record. I said, forget it. I adjusted my frame. Waited a little bit longer. Adjusted my frame again. Continued to wait. I was getting really nervous. I adjusted one more time. And just as I did, actually noticed him walk in. Haven't seen him in a while.
How you doing, sir?
How you doing, sir?
What are you doing here?
How you doing, sir?
Long time, buddy.
Long time.
How are you? How are you?
The family.
Have a seat. I saved you a seat here.
Yeah, of course. Thank you.
That's all that matters.
How you been?
Good. Long time.
Yeah.
How's school?
Everything's good. School's good. I'm stuck in this situation, actually.
Why?
something's going on with school. I have to do a documentary, which I'm not really...
It's not your favorite.
It's not my favorite. You're the guy with the big ideas.
You're going to do
So I'm stuck here doing a documentary. Actually, I'm dreading it. And I'm even dreading the fact that we have to record.
Here, let me get us in frame here a little bit.
You know that a documentary is a great art. Right?
It's a great art, but it's not my type of art.
I know, I agree with you. You want the big idea, and you're a good one.
Yeah.
Because you have the big ideas.
I do have the big ideas. I was trying to get a hold of... you remember my friend Jackie?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, I was trying to get a hold of my friend Jackie, but we're kind of in a little bit of a conflict right now.
Why?
So I don't even want to explain.
It's good, though.
Just some nonsense. She just got home right now. Let me see if I can just get her to apologize. Jackie, just let me talk to you. No, just let me talk to you. Just let me talk to you.
No, I'm mad at you.
Why? What did you... Come on, just let me talk to you.
Did you apologize?
No, I didn't apologize.
Okay, so then you kill me.
Okay. Well, I attempted to get a hold of her. I wanted to get her perspective on a few things. She knows, I was going in a direction of centering a documentary on art and the hip hop world of art. I don't even know. You probably don't even know too much about it.
A little bit.
But we had a little bit of a conflict, and she wasn't happy with that.
You collaborated with her before, so
yeah,
we've worked
before together. Yeah. So whatever. I was attempting to do that. Like yesterday, we were out at Jack Astor's. I was with Chris and the little ones.
Well, how's they doing?
They're okay. They're just little jumping beans. They're all over the place.
Three?
No, the little one's three. The older ones, I think she's going on six or seven. She's in grade one.
Oh my God.
What is that? Seven?
Seven.
Yeah, that's seven. So anyway, so I was, so that's why I was like, you know, and trying to figure it out. That's why I texted you yesterday, and I was like, you know, what, you want to meet up for a coffee, blah, blah, blah. So that's my problem now. My problem now is that I don't know what to do, and I can't get a hold of Jackie. Well, I can get a hold of Jackie, but I wasn't...
You know who's a good person to talk to, probably?
Who?
Uno. You remember Uno?
The artist, yeah.
He is probably the right guy.
I emailed him about he's very private. That might be the bad thing. I emailed him about a month ago, and you know, maybe I should touch base with him. He was in London.
He was in London.
I think he was doing an exhibition in London. So I emailed him a month ago. Maybe even more. I might be lying. I don't even remember. I didn't touch up with him. Maybe I should get a hold of him.
He's probably the right man. And the reason I say that, because he's private, he understands more than most people about censorship and about privacy.
Yeah.
About, you know what I mean? So
you think he would want to do something like... You think he would want me to talk to him?
Well, because he knows you, right?
That's the difference.
Yeah. As I said, he's a private guy, but he knows you, and he knows you well. So he's totally the right man.
Yeah, I don't want to... See, this is why I hate documentaries, because I don't want to bother people. Especially because... even with me, in a sense of when I do anything to do with art or anything I do with me, it's writing. Like, I don't want to be bothered, you know?
Sometimes, though, you have to.
I know, unfortunately. Like now. Like now. We're stuck here.
We're going to the movie.
Shout out to the fact that I'm the youngest nigga doing it. Cap on Brim, Ben, Denzel, every time. She ain't trying to pop that shit for
him. So here I was. I was going to take Tommy's advice. I was going to get a hold of Uno and attempt to interview him. I mean... We're talking about Uno Hoffman. Yes, he's a good friend of mine. He's also, you know, very well known throughout Europe, USA, as the youngest artist to mount solo exhibitions in huge, huge galleries around the world and museums around the world, from Europe all the way to Asia, you know what I mean, to North America. We're talking about Berlin, Paris, Lisbon, Barcelona, everywhere all over the States, New York, Los Angeles, Toronto, in Canada, and you know, back to England, and all over. And here I am, gonna risk my friendship with this guy for something that, a documentary, something that I don't even want to really pursue in a profession. But this is what it was. And I was worried, and I didn't know how to really, really take it. and I don't know if I should continue on this path, getting into the Canadian hip-hop scene and getting into that type of an art form. I mean, it was so diverse, I couldn't centralize it, but doing what I really like and talking about canvas, I mean, I love that. I personally own 2 Hoffmans. So you know what? I said, let me get a hold of my friend. Let's see what can happen.
Seven in the morning, 7:13. I literally just got the message. Here, back in the city last week, free early morning, 9 o'clock, coffee, catch up. So, I guess we're off.
So his reply came through probably when I was sleeping, but I took full advantage of it because it took so long to get a hold of him, and I told him, let's meet for 9 a.m. I jumped right on the opportunity. I didn't want to wait much longer, and I didn't want to lose the opportunity to meet up with him. He picked a Starbucks location at Young and Bloor to meet for 9 a.m., and that was in the Yorkville area of Toronto. I also owned a diner in that Yorkville area for about 10 years in my 20s, so I knew the neighborhood well. So I took advantage of the location as well, down at Davenport and the Avenue section of Toronto, and I stopped. There are some beautiful art galleries there on curbside, where there's several artists depicting their imagination on canvas and display it to the public. It's a beautiful scene. And of course, while there, I also got the JoJo statue, the infamous JoJo statue, and that again is from a good friend of mine's restaurant. I arrived early, a half hour early to be exact. Nervous was an understatement. Not because he's Mr. Hoffman, but to me, he's my friend. But the knowing of a running camera and not telling my friend, I think it was that. And that invasion of privacy between 2 artistic friends, I think it was that. And then he showed up.
Long time.
How you been?
I've been
good.
I am a stud.
You're
always
stud.
What are you talking about?
Coffee's on me, my man.
Don't pull up a chair. I got a chair here. Pull it up, man.
That's not for me. That's for my guests.
Oh, for your guests, your software.
My software.
Coffee's on me. She's got some money there for you. So get whatever you like, bro. Oh, the lady that's at the cash. Just tell her some gentleman just purchased a coffee for me. She'll know.
She'll know.
She'll know. She'll. What a champ. So he brought a briefcase. That's good. Maybe he's working on some art that we can definitely see. And just happy to see him. Haven't seen him in so long. It's been a very long time.
So what can I say? Just like old buddies, we started to catch up right away. This man was one of my biggest inspirations while in my 20s. He covered his visit in London. He told me about his 3 exhibitions coming up in the year ahead. we discussed the impact his art does in different parts of the world, and how he preps his art for specific metropolitan cities worldwide. We talked about his different studios, his latest projects, his newest commissions. We discussed Banksy, Keith Haring, Warhol, Mondrian, Paul Klee. And after all of that, he was determined to hear and see what I was up to. My art, my films. And with that, he's probably a big reason as to why I'm here in the first place. He was the one who told me to fly when I was younger, hanging out in his studio admiring his 12-foot by 12-foot wall work. All this was the reason why I was so hesitant into filming him to begin with, taking our personal conversations and exposing it to the world. But who is this really about? Did it even matter anymore? Uno then opened his briefcase and exposed his images of his beautiful work. At that point, art speaks.